Hello guys, welcome to this webinar. First of all, guys, before starting to all those things, just give me a sound check whether I'm audible or not. You can write in the comment section if I'm audible, yes, if no, and no, obviously. I think this process will be taking 5 more seconds. Okay, perfect guys. So welcome to this webinar by Geeks for Geeks, and I, Ayushman Bansal, invite all of you on behalf of entire and very much thank you to be here. And we are really privileged to have Ansh with us. So guys, Ansh will be joining us very soon, like within next 30 seconds. Until then, you can ask your friends who are the fan of Bit Intact or maybe who are looking up for cybersecurity. So today I have the founder of Bit Intact itself, Mr. Ansh, with me. So yeah, it's starting, like I'm starting from scratch itself. So guys, just do one thing. Let's invite him in an innovative way. So whosoever cybersecurity at most, just hit him 1, 2, 3. Okay, we'll be counting 1, 2, 3. So let's see how many enthusiasts are there. Let's do a count. Okay, wow. Aha, I can see some numbers. Great. Come on, guys, come on, come on. I think let's reach to 200 and Ansh will be here. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. That's amazing, man. That's amazing, actually. Okay. All right. So, guys, Ansh has arrived. So, I'm really privileged and I'm just welcoming him to the stream. Hi, Ansh.
Hello, guys.
Very healthy. I don't believe there is any need to introduce you with the audience. Audience are really amazing. And see, I asked them, let's count it to 1 to 200. So people are writing directly 200. And you have been an amazing to these people.
The response is insane. The response is insane.
Yeah. So maybe I think there are some people who might not know you. So if you can just give up a brief about yourself and what exactly is Bit Intact.
Okay, so I am Ansh Bhavnani. I'm basically a student, a cybersecurity enthusiast or an information security researcher, you can say. So I have been working in this field for 3 to 4 years and I have my own YouTube channel named Bit Intact, in which I give tutorials, practicals, all related to cybersecurity and ethical hacking. And if you have any doubt or any concept that you want to clear in cybersecurity, then I have made almost many videos on every topic. So that's basically what I do. I teach people, I train people, I have made courses. I'm basically a trainer. So that's what I do. That's basically me. I have been in this 3 to 4 years now.
Wow, that's amazing to hear from you itself, Ansh. So Ansh, one thing that I hope many of the audience, they'll be also having a same question. So that is how exactly you initiated and taken an initiative to start the channel Bit Intact. And since I was really surprised when I came to know Ansh has just graduated or even he's about to graduate. But he is someone who have done and helped a lot to multiple peoples in cybersecurity. So how exactly you have moved to that particular field?
So the story I start might be quite interesting for many of us. It was in my school time. When we go back to my school, I changed my school. I started studying in class 9. I think, it is this time, class 9. So I have made many friends, many new friends. At that time, I was very curious and very fond of gaming, computer gaming. I remember I have played like many games like GTA, NFS. There was a game like NFS Most Wanted. So I played a lot, and my friends also. So I had some friends, like I had two friends. One friend was not like that technical and one was very technical. I came to know about that. So like I heard from him like many times that he used to play by modding the game, by changing the values, by hacking, like hacking the game and cracking, like modding and everything. I used to listen these terms from him. I really didn't have any idea about any of these terms. I was just blank. I was just figuring out in my mind, what the heck is he saying? I don't know what yeah, this thing is. So I was very curious. I asked him, I also wanted to play like him. Like he said, I bypassed this restrictions and I play like I want to play. So I also wanted to do that. But when I got to know, when I searched on the internet, I didn't find anything. Or even if I found, I didn't understand how to mod a game, how to crack a game. Like he used some hex editors to change the values and he played like to hit level 7 to 10 like that. I was not able to do that. When I asked him, he didn't tell me, like it was out of ego or something like that. I don't know. But it just really sparked my mind that what all this is. So I went to home and whatever the speed of internet I had, I searched it, I used it fully for this thing. And I was somewhat able to do some modding. I somewhat like did like gaming, like mod. I modded the game and I played it. It was really very fascinating for me. It was childish. I know it was very childish. So basically I had my interest from that point only. I was a child. I did childish things. I came into this field when I searched, when I digged deeper, and then I came to know what real world hacking is. And it's been around 6 to 7 years up till now. So in these 7 years, I have learned a lot. I have been in CS like from past 4 years, I've been doing BTech. So now I know what real world hacking is, but when it was all started, this is the story. So here I came from game modding to information security researcher. That basically is my story.
Wow, that's amazing, guys. I think like many of us have played the crack games. Because yeah, in India, I know like when we were actually young, when we were actually at the age when in our plus twos. So there is nothing like that. Because if let's say if I want to play a GTA, at that time, like GTA was costing something. I remember I bought one of the games. So the CD was something around 6,000 rupees. So at that time, 6,000 actually sounds a very good amount. Like, I still remember, like, my father told me, see, I am giving you 6,000 rupees. Don't buy this game. I'll buy a new cell phone in this 6,000. So it was a kind that's actually fantastic. Like, you use that thing in a particularly in a great way. That's great. So, Ansh, let's not waste much of the audience and yours time as well. So let's come directly to whatever exactly today we are here. So, guys, today we are here to discuss few really important concepts and specifically the need of cybersecurity. So I hope like all of you might be agreeing with my point itself. Like cybersecurity is something which every company, every industry, they are needing right now because the increase in the cybercrime is very much in recent future. So let's skip that part, like why exactly it is needed. So, Ansh, let's come on to the first question, that is, what are the various cybersecurity skills that are actually in demand currently?
Currently in the industry, right? So, yeah, when exactly. We see from job perspective or job point of view, the skills basically depend on the company or the position that you are applying for. Because there are a lot of dependencies, there are a lot of specifications that you are having in this field. Like cybersecurity or ethical hacking is a very general term. I think like people say hacking, you are learning hacking? No, I'm learning penetration testing. I'm learning like forensics. I'm learning malware analysis. So these are the specific terms that you need to go into. Hacking is very big. Hacking is like a whole ocean and you need to dive in a particular field so you can have some jobs and career in that. So it is very general. You need to go specific, like what you want to do. Like you want to do bug bounties, like you want to do forensics, or you want to go to cryptography or malware analysis or pen testing. What you need to do, that you need to decide. And according to that, jobs are decided. There are many job titles, Like if you're doing pen testing, penetration testing, you need to test company's infrastructure. Like a company has its IT infrastructure in its premises, or even if it is a cloud solution, then many of the computers are there. Many web servers, DNS servers, FTP servers, all these are digital assets of a company. So you need to apply like that. You need to have like a job specification. You need to go to the company's website, their openings. You need to see like what are they demanding. Like, for example, they particularly demand what they are using currently in their tech stack. Like if they're using Apache web server, they will demand your Apache skills. If they're using backend Java, they will demand Java. Or there are some basic skills that you need to know, like networking is very important in hacking. So you need to know internet and networking in a very basic way and very conceptually you need to be sound. And then you need to be familiar with Linux, because Linux is a first choice for every hacker, because you are very flexible in Linux. You can do many type of attacks. You can many type of security applications are there, many pre-installed applications are there. So it is very easy to use Linux. And most of the web servers are just relying on Linux only. So you need to learn that. And it is not important to learn programming language, but for me, I will recommend to learn programming, because when you are cracking a code, you cannot do that unless you know how it works. So that is what you need to do. Like there are many specific skills. Like if you want to do a SOC job, security operations center, you need to audit the infrastructure, you need to analyze, you need to make sure that every security solution is in place. And if any incident happens, if any attack happens, then you need to report it immediately. You need to take actions. These are like management jobs. So different skills will be required for this one. And there are many like SIEM, like digital forensics. Forensics, like if any incident happens, you need to take log records, like analyze what has happened and extract data from storage devices like hard disk, floppy drives, yeah, means or USB drives like that. And there are many malware analysis fields. Like you need to take a malware that is currently in the market, very popular and very devastating. You need to analyze it. You need to statically or dynamically test it, how it works, and develop a counter solution for it. So there are many fields, and these skills are basically required, and they're specific.
That's actually, I think, complete answer. Like it's a more than a complete answer. That's perfect. So Ansh, let's start with this thing. Like once I have seen a comment, like one of the users have also asked, like what is the scrap level? Let's say if someone who just know ethical hacking, or let's say about cybersecurity. Let's talk about ethical hacking afterward. Let's talk about cybersecurity right now. So who only heard the term cybersecurity? He don't know anything about cybersecurity. So what would be the first step, or maybe the concurrent step that he or she should be taking?
Okay, so cybersecurity, as I said, it is a very general term, because it is a very big field. Like if you say cybersecurity, there are many specifications, and ethical hacking is a part of cybersecurity, because you won't hack just for hacking sake. You will hack to report it and to analyze and to make sure that it is fixed, to make it secure. You need to do like that. So hacking is like that. We as a security researchers, we do offensive stuff. We penetrate into systems, we find bugs, and we report them so that the companies, the people responsible, can fix it and secure their systems. That is what particular hacking means. That is what's the standard definition of hacking. So in cybersecurity, there are many terms, as I said. So if you want to go in cybersecurity, the first step might be to understand what it means and to understand the terms that are being involved here, like hacking, like security assets, cyberspace. So means like what all things that it is, bugs, issues, vulnerabilities, flaws, threats, like these terms you need to understand. And what type of specifications are in these terms, yeah, that you need to understand. So first of all, you need to clear your prerequisites in hacking. Like if you don't know anything in computer science, or even if you are very beginner, you know some programming, you know some computer fundamentals, like how a computer works, how CPU processes, somewhat about operating systems, you can't jump into hacking. You can't directly jump, because there are many prerequisites. Like I said, you need to learn networking first. Your first step should be clear your networking skills. Before networking also, you need to clear your fundamentals. Like you know what a computer does, you know how it works, how file management is done, how Windows environment works, how Linux environment works, how basically processes are managed, how file systems are managed, what are the basic input-output devices. That sounds really childish, but you need to understand that. You need to have your basics clear. So that is why I need to say that. And then you can go for networking. Networking is a very crucial step. You are going to work on internet. You are going to work remotely. Even if it is on a network, you need to have your infrastructure set up. So you need to learn networking and internet. That is very important. And then you should go for a Linux distribution that you find comfortable with. Just go through it, just explore it, learn Linux, gain experience. The simplest one is Ubuntu. You can try it. But for hackers, we usually use like Kali and Parrot and Arch Linux, Black Arch. So it is our favorite OS. And now programming you can learn, and I recommend it programming. So don't jump right into hacking. First, you need to know what you are doing, what you should be doing in this field. Many people like, I've seen many people like, you know, many people that people think that hacking is very easy. They build their interest through films, through TV series that signify hacking as a very magical term and very fascinating term. They show a lot of graphical user interfaces. They show 4D spaces, like they have any softwares, they are wearing their hoodie, they are like wearing their mask and having the screen and black background, dark background, and they are having some software, they are running some command in their keyboard, and the screen shows access granted. That is some fascination that is not correct. That is not the real world hacking that we do. So you need to understand what is actually done. It is not easy. It is not that easy. So once you come into this field, I'm not saying I myself have came like from game cracking only, but if you are coming, you don't have to step back. You should not step back. If you are coming, you should go further into it. So understand what real world is and what I told prerequisites that you need to do, and then you can jump into hacking. It is a very specific term. Like if you want to do bug bounty, then you can search on Google. There are many courses available. There are many attacks available. You need to learn attacks. Like in web, there are many attacks. In network pen testing, there are many different attacks. In software pen testing, there are different attacks. So it is very specific. As a general term, it is very difficult to define cybersecurity like what you need to learn. You need to decide where you will go. So that is where I can say.
That's actually true. Like, because what happens whenever someone just hear the terms ethical hacking or cybersecurity, there is something like people used to suggest like this is something negative. But guys, this is not something, or maybe someone who is an ethical hacker, ethical actually means that like doing something in a positive manner. Okay. So that is one way. And secondly, guys, I just saw a comment, Ansh, the guy just mentioned like few companies, few tech giants, few good companies. They pay something around 5 to 6 LPA to those ethical hackers right now, or maybe not ethical hackers, the cyber security experts. Then he's asking like, if we are getting such pay right now, I'll just put it up his question itself. Yeah. Here is okay. The Nitin's questions. So sir, but even top audit firms like EY, PwC pay 5-6 starting with very less compared to with data science. AI guys get from IIT where pay is ranging from 15 or 20. That's hard.
That is the basic problem in India. I think Indians are means like the industry is not well aware about the cybersecurity threats. Like you see the recent Twitter hack, how much it cost. So a simple bug, which is being overlooked by Twitter, costs millions of dollars. But even you can pay some 6 to 7 lakhs or some 10 to 15 lakhs to a security researcher, your work have been done in a much lesser amount. So that company needs to know that this is important. You need to not overlook it, because it is not only about you. It is not confined to your environment. You are storing user data. And in this day, in present world, I think data is the most precious thing you are storing.
That's totally true.
So that is why we only need to create that awareness. We only need to become more and more aware and more like raising candidates in this field and growing our community. So then also then itself, we can like see this problem can be solved like that only.
Exactly. So I know like, this is. So one thing that you mentioned that is about developing a community, and this actually one thing like it's the super awesome thing like you have just said. Because if you are having a community, and see guys, what I personally have seen, because I have been seeing this market like the tech job market since last 3 years. So what I've seen is like AI also, like if you feel about the data scientists and all those things, So this field has also come into the picture like for last 2 years itself. Like before that, people were not very much into that thing because, so I think like for cybersecurity guys, you can just practice. So maybe in next 2 years, you can definitely found some really good job perspective in India. So pointing about the same thing, Ansh, what is your point about jobs in cybersecurity in India? What do you think about it?
I think it is a very, very rising industry. It is a very booming industry now. And I can say that jobs will increase as more and more candidates are coming, more and more awareness has been prevailing in this field. So jobs perspective, it is very great, I can say. But it is very great, not that much in India. We need to create like more awareness that, but in foreign countries, it is much better. Their payout is much better, but it is developing in India also. And many government jobs are also opening in this field. So it is a very great thing. Like you can hack systems, yeah, like you can pen test like government websites and they will pay you a lot of amount. It is also a great thing. But if we talk about companies, if you talk about a bigger perspective, then I can say the jobs are very like competitive. And I know that this field is becoming competitive now. And many, I've talked with many top researchers and security. I know many of them. So they are doing really great job. They are doing jobs in this field. And I know that companies hire people in ethical hacking. And it is very great. It is very rising industry, as I say. But if we talk what you need to do to get a job, and like I see that companies look for public work. You need to create your public work in this field. Like you need to show something that you did. Like they want that you did something. Companies, you should show them what you did in this field, what you are doing. You gain some experience. Particularly, they want your certifications. They focus on certification. There are many certifications in this field. So you can do any of them. Most popular is CEH in this field. So many companies opt for that. You can do that, but they are not at all necessary for learning. For job perspective, you can do that. And it is a truth that that companies require that. But if you have experience, if you are doing internships, if you have a previous job in that, if you are doing some public work like publishing write-ups, publishing tools and techniques on GitHub, so they can come to you and they can hire you by themselves also. They can shortlist you also. So that is a great thing. That is what you need to do, I think.
Sure, Ansh. The last line that you have just mentioned, that is about like, guys, this is actually the need of our, like, right now what happened, like, we have seen like social media has grown a lot. So maybe I particularly talk about the LinkedIn part. So on LinkedIn, yeah. Let's say if you have a really good project on GitHub, and if let's say they have multiple upvotes or maybe the more submissions over there on GitHub on your project, just showcase that project on LinkedIn itself. Because
put it in your resume. That's a great thing.
Exactly. Resume is one thing, you should do it. And similarly, what do you see, like, let's say if you feel some of the good candidates, let's say, or maybe some of the good enthusiasts who are working in the different companies, just ping them or maybe just share them like, sir, this is the new project which I have built up. And this use this particular thing. Let me know if we can have something together or maybe something like that. I'm just taking a very low example. So that is one of the major point. I think a field who does not have a dedicated degree program or something like that, so this is actually the best way.
Yeah, nowadays many like institutes are also offering degrees in cybersecurity. Like we have in India, many professional institutes, universities have degrees specifically in cybersecurity, like masters in sciences in cybersecurity, digital forensics. Like I know that it is a very good thing that they are knowing the importance.
Perfect. So Harsh, if you don't mind, can you share a few of the things? Let's say if there are people who have, let's say, just completed or they are about to graduate. So how exactly, if there is any degree program that they can move up?
Yeah, there are many degree programs. There are universities, like there is one like Gujarat Forensic Sciences University. And then there is Amrita, I think its name is. You can search on Google. I don't exactly remember the name. So there are 2-3 institutions. Apart from this, then you can apply for a cybersecurity degree, particularly in this field. And also companies are very much aware of this, so they hire candidates from this field also. They come to your institute, they will hire you and pay you a good amount. Exactly. So that's a great thing. And I think certifications you can do, but it is not necessary to be skilled to take certifications. They don't define your skills. You can learn from anywhere. Like, I didn't do any certifications. I don't have any certification for me personally. So you can do, if you have interest, you want to, but just stick, like you have, let's say, like you need to focus, you need it as a proof that you did something, then you can go for certifications. Like, there are also some certifications that you can take for practicing your skills at a bigger level. Like, there is one Offensive Security Certified Professional, OSCP. That is a very skilled certification that's completely hands-on. You can do that for skills. That is great. But in India, that's not much required in company's point of view. But you can do it, because if you do it once, then we know that you are really a skilled person.
Perfect. That's actually perfect. So, guys, like, I think, like, the motto of our has been started already. Like, if you have seen, like, the Skill Dependence Day has been started on GFG. So on this Skill Dependence Day, like, this is our first webinar and we are doing a lot more sessions with multiple experts. So on that note itself, like, Ansh, I'll just put it up one question. Like, what happened, let's say, if about cybersecurity or maybe about any of the field, when someone used to learn, so there are multiple difficulties when, like, the candidates used to face at that time. Like, I don't know about cybersecurity. So maybe if you can, like, maybe when you were learning, so what are the major difficulties that you have faced? So maybe it can be an advice to the younger ones who are, nurture ones who are looking to be a master in cybersecurity.
Yeah, there are many mistakes that I have personally faced and I don't want people to face them. So first of all, this field is, you know, that people come to know hacking from very different point of views. So hacking is like a very dangerous term. In India, it is considered as something illegal nowadays. Like, nowadays also many people think that it's something wrong. And many parents also think that's why their children, they don't allow them to do something in this field. So first, the major mistake that people do is being fascinated, being considered as a magical term. Hacking is very easy. No, that's not the case. You need to understand that it is not that easy. You need to understand, first of all, what hacking is, what really actually is. Like, what I faced is that I came from game modding. I came from social media hacking, like phishing also. And then when I looked into Google and some articles like real world hacking that they shown, I was like awestruck, like, what is this? I don't know any of this. So at that time, if I had left this field, I don't think that I would have been in this platform now. So that is what the major thing is. You need to know that what you need to do. If you want to do, then just go for it. If you feel like from internally that this is your passion, like you are being motivated, so you do it. But if you are thinking that it is easy, like one, two buttons hacking, like one software you need to install and then just doing some commands, and no, that is not the case. It's not like that. So first mistake that people do, don't take hacking as a piece of cake. It is not that easy, but I don't say it is impossible. If you are passionate, then you will definitely find it easy. Second mistake is that people think that they know everything. Once they learn, I personally myself feel that I have made many videos. Almost I have made 400 videos in my YouTube channel. But when I particularly like look back towards my topic a year ago that I made video on, I don't really remember all the things that I said in that video. So I myself feel that I have forgotten some more things. So I think like you don't know everything. You should know that. You should definitely learn every day, and you just don't feel like it is enough. Nothing is enough. It is never enough. You need to keep learning. You need to stay updated, because every day new type of attacks, new type of bugs are being reported. So you need to be aware. You need to be regular. That is the second thing. And like I faced, my major problem was to speak publicly. So that is not, I don't think like in this field people will face it. So that is the major problems are in this field. And for example, if I say that you need to learn, then people just ask you everything. Like you need to give us some advices. Like if I need to learn, if I need to learn from a book, then please suggest me the book and also give the links for it. And if it is not available, please upload it and give it the link for it. So this is called spoon feeding, which you will not be considered good for in this field, because you don't like it is very a problem for people in this field, because they just ask you everything. If you are in this field, if people know you, they will just spam your comment section for illegal things also. But I wanted to say that you need to be self-dependent. You need to find things by yourself. There is nobody that can help you in everything. Google is there for you in everything. So just make use of it. We are not that efficient. We don't have much time to solve every of your queries. So that is the major problem that I have seen people facing, because I have received many questions. Like, if I tell them this, you should learn this, you should learn from this, you should learn from this videos or this book, everything, they will just, like they say, give your link or just explain it to me. Or if they find any error in the code, then they will say me to develop a secure code for themselves and give them. So I don't think that they will learn by themselves doing this. So exactly. I think that you should go for exactly. I'm guiding you. I'm saying what you need to do in a simpler way, but you need to grow and on that path individually. That is what I can say.
Sure. That's actually one thing I also remember. So with your one statement, so guys, not about the ethical hacking or maybe about cyber security. If you are a computer science enthusiast, you need to use Google properly. Like this is actually, I think like this should be for one of the lesson like the college should be teaching in the first year itself, like how to use Google properly.
Yeah, that is the biggest problem in today's youth and computer science. Like, if you know how to use Google, then you can be the biggest computer science engineer that people have seen.
Exactly. Because guys, like even for each of the problem, like there are multiple, like across the globe, Stack Overflow is the one of the biggest example. Like, if you have any problem, you just go ahead. You just find the Git code over there. You can definitely get the Git codes over there. And all the people, let's say, who are sitting in the industry, they are using that. So this is one of the things that you should do. Secondly, Ansh, maybe the problem that you have raised over here. So guys, like maybe those who are the subscribers or maybe those who are the viewers of Ansh. So you can do one thing. Let's say if in the comment section you are finding particular person who have been stuck over there. So you can also take that charge. You can help those particular persons, like, because not across, Ansh cannot help all the people over there. So do just crowdsourcing, or maybe if people are like stuck somewhere, so just help them. So that's also one of the viable option I think people can have. All right, so Ansh, let's move some of the questions that I particularly feel. Okay, first question. Ansh, sir, which particular field of cybersecurity is more likely to rise in future?
Yeah. I always wanted to answer this question in particular. So I think I have told it many times, as I have seen in the industry, like the rising need of machine learning combined with cybersecurity, because we don't really know how it is gonna end up into. It can also disrupt the normal working of a business in a negative way, but in a positive way, it can like work as a Brahmastra for every people in cybersecurity, because we particularly now without machine learning do only signature based testing or signature based analysis of every like asset that we come across in security. But if we involve machine learning, that then we can have a lots of complexities. We need to train our models, we need to have data sets. That is a lot of complex issue. But if we do that, if we are successful in that, that it can result in a major breakthrough in this industry if we involve machine learning. So cybersecurity and machine learning, I think that it can grow in future. And apart from that, I think IoT security is going to grow, because everything is being available to the internet. In every appliance, you are inserting chips and connecting it to the networks. So I think it is going to be a major issue. And apart from that, I think digital forensics also is going to grow, like cloud security and digital forensics, because there is a need in that. Cloud security, as we are using clouds, as we are going towards cloud computing. So I think security is a major issue there, because many people's data is being hosted, and you get enough access to the cloud. You as a company, you take access at different levels. And if you leave some of the configuration faults, then it is the major entry point for every attack that can happen in the whole infrastructure. Because with your fault, many other data can also be compromised. So that is a major issue in cloud. So that is what I think these industries may be in rise in future. And apart from web security, Android security is also going to happen, like booming, and iOS security also. These are not that much great, but previous ones are very good.
Sure. So guys, like as Ansh answered, so that is like ML, IoT, these are the major things that you can focus on. So Ansh, one more question I was having. Let's say if someone who is moving into this field, so first of all, like you suggested, like between like one should know and one should read the code, like what is written, then only you can jump into the cybersecurity field.
Yeah.
So like maybe few of the people were commenting about the languages part, like what language is necessary, is DS is necessary or not. So what is your advice in that case?
If talking about data structures, I don't feel that it is that required in cybersecurity, because you don't need to understand like the core concept of coding. You just need to understand how it is being applied, how it is working, how the control flow is going from this input to that output, the way, where the connections are being made. So I don't think DS is much necessary, but coding point of view, you need to have basic understanding in every language, in every major language, because when you go to web, you are told to pen test a website and you need to know what it is being made from. Like if it is involving SQL, you need to learn SQL. If it is involving PHP, you need to learn PHP, how it works, you to understand the code. I'm not saying that you need to dive deep and just code into that. You need not code into that. You just need to understand it. Like there are basic like echo functions, like classes and objects, like basic things that everyone learns in programming. That is what you need to learn. There's no need to learn syntax. There's just major like basic concepts in every language like Java, Python, because you don't know what type of website you are going to get next to pen test, or like what you are going to get in networks to pen test, like that. So basic understanding in every language to learn the code, to understand the code is necessary, but not that like you need to go deep into a language. No, you need to go deep into one language. I recommend to go into deep in one language, because you should develop your own scripts to pen test a system. Because in hacking, what we do is that someone else has made the code and posted it on GitHub, and from years and years we are keeping use. Like if I want to do SQL injection, there is a tool called SQL Mac, and we are using it from years, and the same developer. So like I find it like many people, if they are using code, if they are using these tools, they didn't know what they are doing. They are just using the tool and they are hacking the websites. They don't know what internally is being going on, how it is being hacked. So that is what makes them script kiddies. We call them script kiddies. They just know how to use scripts. And you are using scripts. You are just using scripts. You don't know anything. Then what is the difference? What is the difference between you and a normal programmer? He also knows how to run scripts in languages like that. So as a security researcher, you need to research. You need to know what is being going on in backend, what you need to learn. So that is what I'm saying. The best language to learn to make scripts, you need to make your own scripts, is Python. Python is the easiest and very sought after language, and everyone is using it. I call it ALU in programming languages. So you can do everything in Python these days. And also you can learn Bash, because in Linux, like current shell is Bash shell. So you can learn Bash also. You need to make, there are many scripts in Bash. So Bash, so you can learn both of this, two scripting, but not everything. You need to learn basics or have everything, just need that.
Okay. That's perfect. So Ansh, like we have one question over here. So I'm 13 years old, I learned basic of networking and it's fundamental. Wow. Like at a 13, if someone who is real and is doing, that's fantastic. And for programming languages, add on. I'm familiar with Linux environment. Amazing, yeah. What to learn after it to become a cybersecurity expert? So first of all, like salute from my side, buddy.
Yeah.
If actually you are 13 years old.
Basically, yeah. If it is true, then you are very ahead of your age. Like if you are good in networking also, programming languages also, you know, you are familiar with Linux, then all your prerequisites are already fulfilled. You just need to step up in the industry. You need to come as a cybersecurity expert, means you need to learn first, then you can be an expert very easily. Like, I don't like to call experts in this field because nobody is expert. Nobody does know everything. And we keep learning. We keep like teaching others. We keep helping in community. We give and we take. That is what we are doing in the whole industry. So you need to just step up. You need to step in. You need to learn the concepts, cybersecurity. You need to learn the attacks on the networks. You need to learn the basic terminologies like industries are using. You need to understand the job requirements. That is what you need to do. You are well equipped with every knowledge. Just step up in this field. Just step up in cybersecurity and learn basically everything. Everything that that is in this field, like basics of forensics, malwares, sniffing, spoofing, pen testing, web pen testing, or cryptography, Linux, like you know Linux, okay, that's fine. So basically learn all of them, and whatever you like, whatever you feel comfortable, whatever, like in cryptography, you feel that you love it a lot. Like in forensics, you feel that you can do it, or in web penetration testing, you think that you can do it very easily, that's your passion, then go ahead with it. Do like, first your focus should be like very wide, and then you decide where you will go deep. So then come as a deep. So that is what my methodology was. I basically know in many fields of cybersecurity, like basic knowledge, but my major field of interest is web pen testing. So I'm working majorly in that. But as a trainer, I need to know basic of everything. So that is what I do. So all the best for your career, buddy.
Okay, thanks. So guys, I can see like many of the candidates are flooding questions on how to get a job or maybe how to start with it. So already like we have discussed the second part of it, that is how to start with the cybersecurity. So you can just head up on, let's say 15 to 20 minutes before the webinar. You can find the complete details. So one more thing, guys. Okay, just leave the ages, guys. Let's move ahead. So Ansh, second thing, we can ask about the people about the ethical hacking, because that was also the initial time of the webinar, like people were asking about the ethical hacking. How to be with that, or let's say how to start with it. So
ethical hacking as a career, you need to work as an offensive personnel. Because hacking means doing things, attacking things, pen testing, like getting into softwares, penetrating into softwares, and just finding flaws in the codes. So in cybersecurity, it is a part of, like, ethical hacking is a part of cybersecurity. You need to first hack into the code and then secure it. So your work is to find security vulnerabilities and to report them to the companies. Because nowadays, I'll tell you that companies are not that much aware of this threat in today's day also, because we have seen recent attacks like Twitter and many companies like being attacked nowadays. Many softwares are being attacked. Many flaws are being published every day. And many flaws are like that we don't know about. We don't know about. They are just being hacked, and companies being hacked, and millions of dollars are being given into that. But some statistics show that every 39 seconds hacking attacks are being happened every 39 seconds, and roughly a cost of a data breach in the United States is like about $8 million per data breach cost, is like that. So we need to understand the need of cybersecurity. And in the company, we know that it is not only related to companies. You are storing lots and lots of amounts of data, and your digital assets need to be secure, need to be under control. So you need to take full control over it. You can build firewalls. You can build security solutions. There are many vendors that give security solutions to companies as clients. You can approach them. There are many like Acunetix, Qualys. There are many companies that provide solutions, firewalls, etc. So in ethical hacking, you can start to work as, like I said, you need to clear your prerequisites and then come as a hacker. You need to do pen testing. You need to, if you want to go bug bounty, then it is a freelancing job. It is just like a pen testing, but in pen testing as a job, you will do in the environment of the company itself. You will not do anywhere else. You will work on their own scope. They will show them their policy, what you have access into, what you need to test. and you are under control of them. But in bug hunting, you don't have any control. You just need to attack in scope items. You can use anything. Like in pen testing, you may be told that you cannot use this tool or you can use only this one. That is the limited scope that you have. But both of them particularly, like generally, are the same. Like you need to do testing only. So testing means hacking. In like naive terms, you can say it is hacking. So hacking, if you say, again, I say ethical hacking is very general. There is no job. There is no job position named as ethical hacking, truly, if I say, because as I said, penetration tester is a job. SOC analyst is a job. SIEM, like forensic investigator, malware analyst, they are jobs. They are means security engineer, security analyst. These type of jobs are there. But as an ethical hacker, there is no job. You need to understand what company requires, and then you need to learn that. You want to apply for Google, you want to apply for any other company, then just look into LinkedIn. They like just explore, just see their job requirements and then learn. First, I said that basic, what is the course of CEH, like Certified Ethical Hacker? You should do that. I'm not saying to take certification. I'm not saying to take certifications like giving exams and like spending thousands of like rupees. It is not required. Just go through the syllabus and learn it. It is the very basic thing that you need to learn in ethical hacking. It is a very great course. People say, like, people have a very great misconception about the certification that it is very basic. You are wasting your time doing that. No, it is not waste of time. It is very fundamental and you should learn that. And it is the entry point for you in cybersecurity. So I recommend in ethical hacking, first, complete your CEH syllabus. Go to the EC Council website, which is the official body for providing CEH, see their syllabus and just learn it from anywhere you can. I have also made courses, then you can also learn from many courses. So in ethical hacking, I recommend that. And after that, what you feel right in whatever field you feel comfortable, just go into that. And what is important in this field is hands-on, very important thing. And in search of hands-on and in the pursuit of hands-on, people generally lose their like conceptual mind. They just leave concepts. It is not recommended. It is a very big problem, I personally feel, because I ask theoretical questions to people, they are not able to answer. So that is what theory plus practical, both you need to learn in equal amount. You need to give your time. It is not a one day task. It will take you years. And you need to have patience because you need to search it by yourself and just keep learning. There are many platforms. There are many testing labs online that you can practice skills on online, like softwares, like OWASP is the best solution where you can practice your skills. It has many applications. It had many software solutions and like tools that you can use for testing. So just you need to keep exploring and then you are good.
Exactly, guys. The much someone can explore, the much they can learn. Like these are the things, yeah. Like we are listening to these type of things from childhood itself. But guys, like if you are implementing, then definitely these things will be helping you out a lot.
Yeah, one thing. Okay. One thing I want to tell you that at my time when I started learning, there were not many resources that I can refer, because at that time the internet was also not that much good. No Jio was there. So whatever the speed I had, whatever the resources I had, I have learned with limited resources. So nowadays I see like nowadays there are many resources available, like thousands or millions of videos, write-ups, articles, research papers, everything is available. Still people are like, you should spoon feed us. No, that's not the case. We have learned in limited environment. So you are very lucky that you got everything that you need. You don't have to spend much time that we had to spend at that time. So it is a very big thing. People should take advantage of whatever is available, what people are contributing. They should take them and they should also contribute back. So that's how the community works. That is the basic principle.
Perfect. So Ansh, since you have mentioned about the time and all those things, like I personally believe like this time, although this is very hard situation for all across the world, like the world is going with COVID-19 pandemic, but still I feel like if someone who want to utilize this, like who just want to learn something, so this is actually one of the best time. Like,
yeah,
anyone can explore or anyone can utilize this time. What do you say about it?
Definitely, it's the biggest need of the hour because you are given this time, and time, you know how precious it is. So utilize it. As like in these days, you know that security issues like have been increasing at a very big rate because everything is being digitalized. So as digital as you are becoming, the more entry points you are introducing in the cyberspace to get attacked. So this field is totally dependent on it. As digital as you get, this is going to increase. So this is the basic principle, as I say. So that's what I think. You should utilize this time as much as you can. Like I have been doing, like I have been reading books, I have been reading articles, I have been making much of my videos. Like I say, like in one day, I almost make 4 to 5 videos, practicals included. And for videos or for YouTubes, I do like separate work. I do separate work on my courses. I teach people. I also give some webinars elsewhere also. So that is what I'm doing right now. I'm learning and I'm giving. Whatever I have learned from the past 3 to 4 years, I'm just giving it back immediately, what I have learned. And basically the major principle I started teaching people on YouTube is that I used to search when I was learning, when I was very beginner in this field, I was learning and I searched for terms and technologies and concepts on YouTube in Hindi. So what I saw was like I saw many videos, but I didn't see like that much of clearance or understanding in knowledge that increased. So that is what I feel that it is lacking in this industry. So I decided, why not what I feel is lacking, I should make, so others will not be like what the problem I am facing, others should not face that. So what was missing, I made the concepts clear. I made Hindi videos. Many people don't know that when I started YouTube 1.5 years, I just made videos in English. So when people told me to make in Hindi, and I also saw the need, so I ultimately switched to Hindi. And that's why I'm here now.
Okay, that's fantastic. One of the good thing. So Ansh, one more thing I just want to ask, that is like, I have seen few of the comments on the same thing. That is like, people want to know about the big bounty program, like how okay. They can get an update about it and what exactly that stands for.
Bug bounty basically is that you approach like companies give you opportunities to hunt on their websites, to find security bugs on their websites. They allow you. They voluntarily allow security researchers all over the world. They like create a policy like what you can hunt, what is in scope, what all tools you can use, what all things you can use. And what assets you can use for pen testing, what are in scope basically. So you can test their infrastructure. And if you find any bugs, you can report them. And if your bug is valid, if it can cause like a reasonable impact on the business profit of a company, then it will pay you. Then it will reward you. I'm not saying pay. It will reward you with proper, like very big amount. Like they can give you money in thousands of dollars depending upon the severity of the bug that you found. They can also give you swags, they can give you recognitions, they can give you certificates. Whatever they can give in return, they will pay you, they will reward you. So that is what bug bounty means. Like bugs are that you find and bounties that companies give you back. So that is basically what it means. And this industry has been like booming very much because a lot of security researchers, according to a report in one of the biggest bug bounty platforms, Bugcrowd, India is top in bug bounty researchers in this year, 2020, like 2019. So that is a great thing because people in India are very talented in this field, bug bounty. I have known many researchers where they are doing great jobs. They are going in this field. So rewards are very much, as I said, if you give just 2 to 3 dedicated hours in testing in a company, then you can easily earn around like maximum of $10,000, $20,000, or even $50,000 in just 3 to 4 hours. It depends on the severity of bug that you are finding. So there are lots of rewards in that. And people, like, I don't say that you should do it as a full-time job because it is unstable, because you can find bugs. Like you one time find a bug and next day you might not get any bug. So there is no fixed income, but when it comes in like thousands of So this is the field like, so I basically what I do is that I hunt besides my original work. Even if I do a job, then I will hunt besides, because I cannot do it as a full time because it is very unstable, but it is very good for building skills and getting something in return. So that is like complete package.
Sure. That's actually a complete answer, I could say. So guys, like almost we have been done for this webinar, but you guys can be with us like because this is just the starting of the skill dependence days. So next up will be coming someone who she has been worked with a company like Adobe and Amazon, and she'll be talking about the women programming. And you can see multiple webinars. So at 7, there is one more webinar on it. You can be there. Secondly, guys, just an interesting thing I just want to share. That is like today, the Wheel of Fortune, I guess. So just give me a moment. I'll just check the name because I just forgot it. Yeah, Spin the Wheel is live. So if you want, just try. I have shared the link. Just try that Spin the Wheel. This is something you would love. Like, you can get some rewards over there. So best check out the page and all us. So last phase of advice, anything Anish you want to give to the audience?
If you are starting a career in ethical hacking, then you should be like, you should be a part of the community. It's not like that you are doing separate work and you cannot contribute or you cannot take. It is not any type of ego and all. We are all in this community. We are trying to grow. We are trying to teach people the right way. We are creating awareness. And in India, there is a lot of problem like people face, like they are not understanding what real hacking is. They are just spam your comments like anything. They are just like using hacking for Facebook hacking and social media hacking, game cracking and all. This is like a very backward stuff. Don't focus on that. Just leave it, ignore it. That is not what you are going to do. And first of all, you need to understand what is white hat and what is black hat, because it is a very thin line. Ethical hacking means it is very risky. Hacking field is risky. So what I mean is that you need to know that when you are ethical and when you are not. If you have got permissions to test, then you can definitely do that. You can read properly the policy that the company is saying, that what all assets can you test. And if you go beyond that, then it can pose a problem for you. As a individual, if you are like testing someone else's Wi-Fi or some individuals like networks or websites, then you need to take proper permissions for that. I don't say that I have myself not done any like without permission work, but I have definitely not done any criminal activity that we call it black hat, because like these activities are very dangerous. Your career can be destroyed with that. So don't do that black hat activities. Don't hack anyone's Facebook account without any permission or anything like that. And hacking Facebook and Android phones is not actually hacking. You are just like phishing. You are just like tricking the minds of people and taking their passwords from them. That is not real hacking. That is like chalawa, you can say. And like if you are going to be really serious in this field, then you need to know what white hat is, what gray hat is, and what black hat is. Gray hat is like you don't have permission, but you don't do something illegal. So that is okay. If you are under the terms and conditions, that is, it is okay, but I don't really recommend it. Just go for white hat, stick to it, and you gain respect, you gain rewards, you gain lots of knowledge. Just go into this field, yeah. I just like, just for dalo.
agreed, buddy. Like, you have been helping the students a lot, so I hope they are also getting a very much advantages. Maybe near future, you can get more and more testimonials from the candidates itself, because you have been a lot more helping to the candidates. So a really great thanks, Anish, you join us today. And thanks to all the audience who have been us. So guys, like, you can just like this video, or maybe some of your friends who are not able to join us today, you can just pass on the link, because the webinar will be there itself on YouTube. And subscribe to the GFG channel, because on these 3 days, you'll be getting a lot more learning activities.
I also wanted to say very thank you to Geeks for Geeks for providing me such platform, wow, such big platform to share my knowledge, to share my like experience with people. And it feels really good. We want to grow our community and we want to make India secure, a very big tech like cybersecurity giant, and competent with other companies also, other world giants also like US and all. So it's really great. Thank you so much.
Fantastic. Okay, guys, thanks for joining us today. See you back at 7. Goodbye.